We're here to learn what 1 plus 1 is. 1 plus 1, a mathematical equation so simple, yet so profound. It's a concept that has been understood by humans for thousands of years, and yet it still holds a certain level of mystique. The answer, of course, is 2. But is it really that straightforward? Let's dive deeper. The concept of 1 plus 1 is based on the fundamental principles of arithmetic, which were first formalized by the ancient Greeks. The Greek philosopher and mathematician Euclid is often credited with being the first to formalize the rules of arithmetic, including the concept of addition. In his seminal work, The Elements, Euclid laid out the principles of arithmetic, including the concept of 1 plus 1. But Euclid's work was built on the discoveries of earlier mathematicians, such as the Babylonians and the Egyptians. These ancient civilizations had a deep understanding of arithmetic and were able to perform complex calculations, including addition. So when we say that 1 plus 1 is 2, we are building on a foundation of mathematical knowledge that stretches back thousands of years. But what does it really mean to say that 1 plus 1 is 2? At its core, arithmetic is a system of counting and measurement. When we say that 1 plus 1 is 2, we are counting the number of objects or units that we have. In this case, we are counting 2 objects. But what are these objects? Are they physical objects, like apples or chairs? Or are they abstract objects, like numbers or concepts? The answer is that they can be either. Arithmetic is a flexible system that can be applied to a wide range of objects and concepts. When we say that 1 plus 1 is 2, we are using arithmetic to count and measure the number of objects or units that we have. But arithmetic is not just a system of counting and measurement. It is also a system of logic and reasoning. When we say that 1 plus 1 is 2, we are using logical reasoning to arrive at a conclusion. We are starting with a set of premises or assumptions and using logical rules to derive a conclusion. In this case, the premises are the numbers 1 and 1, and the conclusion is the number 2. The logical rule that we are using is the rule of addition, which states that when we add 2 numbers together, the result is a new number that is the sum of the 2 original numbers. So when we say that 1 plus 1 is 2, we are using logical reasoning to arrive at a conclusion that is based on a set of premises and logical rules. But arithmetic is not just a system of logic and reasoning. It is also a system of patterns and relationships. When we say that 1 plus 1 is 2, we are recognizing a pattern that exists in the world around us. We are seeing that when we combine 2 objects or units, the result is a new object or unit that is the sum of the 2 original objects or units. This pattern is not unique to arithmetic. It exists in many other areas of mathematics, such as geometry and algebra. In geometry, we see patterns in the shapes and structures of objects. In algebra, we see patterns in the relationships between variables and constants. And in arithmetic, we see patterns in the way that numbers relate to each other. So when we say that 1 plus 1 is 2, we are recognizing a pattern that exists in the world around us. We are seeing that when we combine 2 objects or units, the result is a new object or unit that is the sum of the 2 original objects or units. But what about the nature of the objects or units that we are counting? Are they discrete, individual objects, or are they continuous interconnected quantities? The answer is that they can be either. In some cases, we are counting discrete, individual objects like apples or chairs. In other cases, we are counting continuous interconnected quantities like water or sand. And in still other cases, we are counting abstract objects like numbers or concepts. So when we say that 1 plus 1 is 2, we are counting objects or units that can be either discrete or continuous, individual or interconnected. But what about the nature of the numbers themselves? Are they real, objective quantities, or are they simply human constructs created to help us make sense of the world around us? The answer is that they are both. Numbers are real, objective quantities in the sense that they exist independently of our perceptions or understanding of them. But they are also human constructs created to help us make sense of the world around us. We use numbers to count and measure objects and quantities, but the numbers themselves are not the objects or quantities that we are counting or measuring. They are simply a way of representing and understanding those objects or quantities. So when we say that 1 plus 1 is 2, we are using numbers to represent and understand the world around us. We are counting objects or units and using numbers.